Hello friends, I am Darshika Maru, lecturer in English from Bhavseji Polytechnic Institute, Bhavnagar. You have studied many grammatical items such as tenses, determiners, modal auxiliaries, prepositions and others. It means now you are familiar with various kinds of verbs and its uses, and you are also familiar with various kinds of sentence patterns and their uses. Today we are going to discuss about another grammatical item, that is connectors. We will discuss about connectors, its various kinds, its uses, and also their examples. Let us see the PowerPoint presentation about the topic. Connector itself indicates its meaning. To connect, it means to join. Connectors are said to be joining words. They join two or more words, phrases, and sentences. We may say that they can connect two or more words, phrases, and sentences. They express many different relationships between ideas. If there are two sentences and both sentences reveal two ideas, then we can join two sentences with one connector and reveal single idea. Let us see the uses of connectors. Connectors connect or combine ideas in sentence by showing logical relationship between them. They are used to connect ideas, details, or clauses together in order to make one clear detailed sentence. Let us see some examples using different connectors. Here are two words, butter and bread. These two words are connected with a single connector, that is AND. Bread and butter. Bread, butter are two words which are connected with AND. In the second example, I will come in the morning, not in the evening. These two phrases are connected with a single connector, that is BUT. These two ideas are expressed in a single sentence using connector BUT. In the third example, he took a pencil, drew a diagram. These two sentences are joined with a connector, that is AND. These two sentences express their ideas and joined by connector AND. Let us see the different kinds of connectors and its uses by showing examples on PowerPoint presentation. The first connector AND. This is a connector of addition. It adds one statement to another. It adds one fact to another. AND can join two sentence elements such as two nouns, two verbs, two adjectives, two phrases, or two clauses. Let us see the example. Manav is playing cricket. There is another sentence. Rohan is playing cricket. These two sentences are joined with a connector, that is AND. These two nouns, Manav and Rohan, are connected with connector AND. Manav and Rohan are playing cricket. Let us see the example. There are two sentences. Stand up, introduce yourself. These two sentences are joined with AND. The one sentence adds some ideas in another sentence. Stand up and introduce yourself. There are various kinds of connectors. There are various kinds of connectors. The new connectors are but, yet, and still. These old connectors are show contrast. Let us see the first. But expresses a contrast between the previous clause and the one that follows. Contrast is a simple word. We can understand its meaning. But in grammar, contrast means that the central idea of one clause is opposite to the idea in the second clause. So, but, yet, and still are the connectors which show contrast. Let us see the example. He asked for another cup of coffee. There was no more. These are two sentences. First sentence and the second sentence are contrast in some ideas. He asked for another cup of coffee, but there was no more. This single sentence shows contrast between two statements by using connector but. Generally, we use but, yet, and still instead of each other. Yet is a connector used as the preferred alternative to but when we want to emphasize that contrast to achieve a stronger effect. As example, she can play the piano very well, yet she can't read music at all. Yet expresses emphasis and contrast between two sentences. The another example is the machine was out of order. The second sentence, the operator could manage the production work. There are two opposite ideas. We can connect it with connector these two ideas in a single sentence by using connector yet. The machine was out of order, yet the operator could manage the production work. Let us see the connector still. The example are, there is no hope in this case, you may try. There is no hope in this case, still you may try. The other example is, the supervisor was very exhausted, still he continued his work. Exhausted means extremely tired. These both the sentences express opposite ideas. Therefore, it is connected with still. The next connectors are or and otherwise. These connectors express a choice between two or more things or alternatives. There is no option. They have to choose one alternative. Only one of the two conditions exists. The example is keep quiet or go out. These two sentences are keep quiet, go out. We can join with or because you have to select any one option. You should keep quiet or you may go out of the class. Let us see the example of connector R. There are two sentences. Run fast, you will miss the bus. You should run fast or you miss the bus. Run fast or you will miss the bus. You have only one option. There is no another option. Now, let us see the example of otherwise. Work hard, you will fail in exam. Work hard, otherwise you will fail in exam. You have to work hard, otherwise you will not pass in exam. So you have no other alternatives. In this example, we can see that you must speak the truth or you will be in great trouble. You have to choose any one alternative. That's why or and otherwise are used to show one option. There is no another option to select. So and therefore are the connectors which indicate the consequences. Consequences means a result or effect, generally bad or not convenient, as well as the reason. So and therefore are connectors used with independent clauses. You know very well that what is independent clauses. You are now familiar with different kinds of sentence pattern. But let us glance what is independent clause is. Independent clause does not depend upon any other clauses for its full meaning. As example, give us all the helps. Stop criticizing us. Give us all the helps or stop criticizing us. These both sentences are independent. They do not depend on each other for their complete meaning. Let us see the structure of this sentence. You should first write down independent clause that showing reason and connect so or therefore, and then you have to put independent clause showing result. The example is Ria was very tired. This is the sentence or clause which shows reason, and she could not go for shopping. This clause shows result. These both the clauses are joined by so. The reason is Ria was very tired. And the result is she could not go for shopping. That's why so connector is used to connect these both clauses. The example is the road was hilly. She could not walk fast. The road was hilly. Therefore, she could not walk fast. The reason is the road was hilly. And the result is she could not walk fast. These two clauses are connected with therefore. These both the clauses are independent clauses. Let us see the another example. Sunny worked with dedication. She could do well in his final exam. These two clauses are independent clauses. They are connected with so. Sunny worked with dedication. So he could do well in his final exam. We can use therefore in place of so. Sunny worked with dedication. Therefore he could do well in his final exam. In the same way, the another example, Jill remembered my birth date. So, or therefore, she bought me a gift. The connectors of cause and reason are because, since, for, as. These are the connectors which show cause or reason. It means the reason is. These connectors are used with dependent clauses. We can use this clauses by connecting because his electricity was cut off, because he had not paid bill. Let us see about dependent clauses. Dependent clause depends upon the main clause for its full meaning. It does not stand its own. We reached home when the sun set. When the sun set is a dependent clause. It depends on the main clause, we reached home. When the sun set does not express the full meaning of the sentence. The connectors of clauses explain why something happens. We can use a reason clause introduced by these connectors. The sentence pattern of this clause are clause of result, because, since, as, for, and then clause of reason or cause. I left the party. This clause shows result. I was not feeling well. This clause shows reason. I left the party because I was not feeling well. We can use because, since, as, and for in the beginning of the sentence also. So how can we write this sentence? Let us see the structure first. We can put because or since or as or for in the beginning of sentence, and we have to put clause of reason in clause. Then we should put clause of result. Let us see the example. Since the manager has come early, he may call the meeting soon. See that since is in the beginning of the sentence. We may put because the manager has come early, he may call the meeting. We can also use the another connector instead of since. People did not like Galileo. He questioned the beliefs of his elders. People did not like Galileo for he questioned the beliefs of his elders. For is also the connector of causes and reason, but it is used very formally. Generally, we are using because, since, and as. Because of is also the connector of cause and reason. Due to, on account of, owing to are also used to show cause or reason. These are the connectors which are following by a phrase or phrases. Now you are familiar with independent and dependent clauses. But what about phrase? It is also very well known to you, but let's just glance on it. Phrase is a group of words which makes sense but not complete sense. It cannot stand on its own. It does not have a finite verb or a subject. Let us see the structure of these closes. Close showing result, then we have to put due to, because of, on account of, owing to. Then phrase showing reason and cause. When we have discussed about because, since, for and as, we connect the clause, but here we will connect phrase showing reason or cause. The example is, the trip was postponed due to heavy rain. Heavy rain is a phrase. The other example, the students are happy. There is an extracurricular activity. All the students are happy during the extracurricular activity. So how can we connect these two sentences? Let us see. The students are happy because of an extracurricular activity. The students are happy is a clause which shows result. And then we join the phrase with connector because of. An extracurricular activity. It is a phrase. Because of, due to, on account of, or owing to should be placed in the beginning of the sentence also. Then phrase showing reason or cause, and then clause showing result. Because of heavy traffic, I could not reach in time. The examples of due to. Due to Monday, I feel little overburdened. We can put due to in the middle of the sentence also. I feel little overburdened due to Monday. Let us see the examples of owing to. The peon was promoted owing to his hard working. Owing to the peon's hard working, he was promoted. We can put owing to. Instead of owing to, we can also put because of. The peon was promoted because of his hard working. Because of the peon's hard working, he was promoted. On account of is also the connector. Everyone knows him. He is Virat Kohli. He is looking happy. But we don't know why he is looking happy. Let us see. Virat Kohli was declared man of the match on account of his superb performance. Now we know that he is happy because he was declared man of the match. We can put on account of in the beginning of the sentence also. Let us see the example. On account of his superb performance, Virat Kohli was declared man of the match. Though, although, even though, even if. These are the connectors. Though, although, even though, and even if express concession or contrast. Generally, we use such type of words in our sentences, but we don't know these are the connectors, where to use these connectors, when to use. Now see, all these connectors to say that something is surprising, unusual, or unexpected in relation to another things. This is called concession. Though, although, even though, and even if are the connectors of concession. But what is concession? They express an idea that suggests the opposite of the main part of the sentence. They are used with dependent clauses. Even though it rained a lot, we enjoyed the picnic. It rained a lot and we enjoyed the picnic. Both the sentences express opposite ideas. But we can join these two ideas by using connector even though. The structure of this sentences are, we can put though, although, even though, and even if in the beginning of the sentence, and then we can put clause 1 and then clause 2. In the same way, we can put though, although, even though, and even if in the middle of the sentence. At that time, we should put clause 2 in the beginning of the sentence and then connectors. After that, we have to put clause 1. Let us see the example. He is honest. He is poor. These both sentences express contrast ideas. That's why we use though and connect these both the sentence in a single sentence. Though he is poor, he is honest. In the second example, though is put in the middle of the sentence. He is honest, though he is poor. The example of although. He had enough money. He refused to buy a new car. Although he had enough money, he refused to buy a new car. If we put the connector in the middle of the sentence, then as I told you that the second clause should be first. He refused to buy a new car though he had enough money. We can use though instead of although, and also we can use even if or even though instead of though and although. The connectors however and as, they are used to show contradiction or contrast, to introduce an opposing idea, used with dependent clauses. But its structure or sentence pattern is something different. Let us see the structure. If we will put however in the middle of the sentence, clause 2 will be the first, then however and adjective or adverb. After that, subject should be put, then verb and other words. As example, he did not show it, however tired he was. Actually, there are two sentences. He did not show it, he was tired. But in this sentence pattern, after however, there is adjective or adverb. If we put however in the beginning of the sentence, then however, after that adverb, adjective, then subject, verb or other words, after that we can put clause 2. Let us see the example However tired he was, he did not show it. Now, you are clear about this sentence pattern. As is also the connector which has different kind of sentence pattern. In however, we put adverb or adjective after the connector, but in as, in using as, we have to put adverb or adjective before the connector, then subject, verb, other words, and close to. If we put as in the middle of the sentence, same as in however, close to will be the first, then adverb, adjective, and joined as subject and verb. Shreya could not get the first rank hard as she worked. Actually, these are two sentences. Shreya could not get the first rank. She worked hard. But hard comes first and then connector as is used. As we have seen in structure, Shreya could not get the first rank hard as she worked. Hard as Shreya worked, she could not get the first rank. The next connectors are in spite of, despite. These connectors are used to show contradiction. They express that something is unexpected or surprising. In spite of, despite being a millionaire, he lives very simple life. Here, being a millionaire is a phrase. This sentence pattern we can use in the beginning of the sentence, in spite of or despite, and then noun, phrase, verb with ing. After that, we should put close. Let us see the example. In spite of his holiday, he worked for the whole day. These sentences express different or opposite ideas. He worked for the whole day in spite of his holiday. We can put these connectors in spite of or despite in the middle of the sentence also. At that time, we should put close first and then connectors. After that, noun, phrase, or verb with ing can be put. He worked for the whole day despite his holiday. He worked for the whole day in spite of his holiday. Even though he walks fast, he would not reach in time. He would not reach in time even though he walks fast. If is very common in English. Generally, we use this connector, but we don't know the proper use and its meaning. Let us see how can we use, where can we use. This is the connector of condition. It shows condition. It is used with dependent clauses. If you come in time, you will start your presentation first. The condition is you come in time. If all goes well, they will buy a new car. What is the condition? We know very well that all goes well. If all goes well, they will buy a new car. Something will happen if a certain condition is fulfilled. Otherwise, they will not buy a new car. If all goes well, this condition will be fulfilled, then they will buy a car. With this simple present tense in the if clause, future tense in the other clause. See that all goes well is the simple present tense. The another clause, they will buy a new car, is in future tense. If you had asked me, I would have told the truth. If my father had been fine, he would have gone to Chennai. These examples are different from the before examples. In that example, see that. In that example, if all goes well, they will buy a new car. In this, first clause is in simple present tense and the second clause is in future tense. But here, the first clause is in perfect past tense and the second clause is perfect models. So with perfect past in if, perfect models will be used in another clause. The same example is here. If my father had been fine, he would have gone to Chennai. Unless, this is also a very common connector that is used in common language. Unless is actually the opposite of if. If not is equal to unless. It is in the sense of negation. I will not attend the party if he does not invite me. The condition, if condition is not fulfilled, then I will not attend the party. I will not attend the party unless he invites me. See the difference in this both the sentences. Will not attend, he does not invite. See these verbs. In this example, by using unless, I will not attend the party. Here, unless is used, it means unless expresses does not. I won't be able to anchor the program if you do not help me. We can use unless in this sentence also. I won't be able to anchor the program unless you help me. When you change the if clause into unless, then you have to be careful that there should no change in the meaning of the sentence. These are the clauses: who, whom, whose, and which. A dependent clause may refer to a noun or pronoun in the main clause and may be joined with the main clause by such connectors as who, whom, which and whose. Let us discuss about who. Who refers to human being? It is a connector used for the subject in the sentence or a clause. The girls attended the party. The girls were very happy. The girls who attended the party were very happy. But careful, when we use this connector who, we should put this connector who after noun or pronoun that it refers. Otherwise, the sentence might be absurd if we put who here. Let us see. The girls attend the party who were very happy. Then it means who is used with party. It means the meaning is not expressed, or it might look absurd. The boy is speaking on the stage. He is my brother. Here the boy is a noun. Here he is a pronoun used for the boy. The boy who is speaking on the stage is my brother. Let us see connector whom. Whom is a connector which also refers to human being. It is used whenever the objective form of who was required. This is the man whom I gave 500 rupees yesterday. There are two sentences. This is the man I gave him 500 rupees yesterday. Here him is the objective form of man. Therefore, whom is put after man. The Gitanjali was written by Rabindranath Tagore. Gandhiji called him Gurudev. These are the two sentences. We can join these two sentences by whom. The Gitanjali was written by Rabindranath Tagore, whom Gandhiji called Gurudev. Whom is referred to Rabindranath Tagore. Whose is a connector indicates possession. It is used for both living and non-living. Mihir, whose father is a doctor, is my close friend. Chetan Bhagat is a writer. His novels are very famous. We can use whose in this sentence. Chetan Bhagat is a writer whose novels are very famous. We can get the answer whose novels are very famous. The novels written by Chetan Bhagat. It means the position of the novels are with Chetan Bhagat. Which. This is the connector used for animals or inanimate things. The example is, this is the book which I bought yesterday. Here, book is inanimate thing. The dog was injured yesterday. It is my neighbor's pet. The dog is an animal, so we cannot use who. we should use which. The dog which was injured yesterday is my neighbor's pet. Where is the connector which indicates plus, where an action takes place? Saputara is the hill station where we went last year for a week. The structure of this sentence is clause 1. The one clause is ending with plus word. Then we can put where. Then clause 2 is put. Let us see the example. This is the hospital. This is clause 1. It ends with the name of the place, the hospital. This another clause is, my father is working as a doctor. We can join these two sentences by using connector where. This is the hospital where my father is working as a doctor. These two clauses are connected with where. When. This is a connector which indicates time. Usually the word when indicating time is placed before the connector when. Winter is the season when we can enjoy variety of vegetables. The season is indicating time. The structure of this sentence is clause 1, which ends with time word. Then we can put when, and then clause 2. Let us see the example. The earthquake occurred in Gujarat. I don't remember the year. I don't remember the year when the earthquake occurred in Gujarat. Year indicates time. When is a connector. We join these two sentences. Year is a word which indicates time. After that, we have put when. Why is the connector used to indicate reason? Usually word indicating reason is placed before the connector why. Everybody knows the reason why she left the job. The reason is a word which indicating reason, and after that we put why. The sentence pattern is clause 1 with ending reason word, then why, and clause 2. Let us see the example. There was a fire in the factory. The manager wanted to know the cause. Now, here, cause is a word which shows reason. The manager wanted to know the cause. Why there was a fire in the factory? You have studied different kinds of connectors and their uses with examples. The other connector, either or, it is also very common in English. We all are using this connector, but we don't know where to use and which meaning it expresses. Either or expresses a choice between two alternatives. The connector either or indicates any one of them. You must select any one. No preference. Let us see the example by using either or. These are the two sentences. You must know Hindi. You must know English. You must know Hindi. And you must know English. We can connect these two sentences by either or. You must know either Hindi or English. You have no option. You must know any one of these two languages. Neither nor is a connector which is used for negative statement. It means none of them. Either or is the connector which is used to select any one of two. Here, none of them. The pun cannot write in English. He cannot read English. The pun can neither write in English nor read it. These are sentences which express negation. My father will not go for a dinner. My mother will not go for a dinner. We can join these two sentences by using connector neither nor to express the meaning in negation. Neither my father nor my mother will go for a dinner. It means none of both will go for a dinner. Not only but also is a connector which indicates both of them. We have studied that in either or you have to select any one option. In neither nor, none of them. But here, not only but also, it means both of them. The verb of the sentence depends on the subject given after but also. Not only Professor Sharma, but also his students are hardworking. See here, Professor Sharma is a singular noun. But here, his students is a plural noun. The verb are hardworking. Here are agrees with this noun, his students. As I have told you, the verb of the sentence depends on the subject given after but also. After but also, there is a noun that is plural. That's why we are using here are hardworking. The other example is, my uncle lost his purse. He lost his identity card also. My uncle lost not only his purse, but also he lost his identity card. Both and. This is the connector which indicates both of them. There is no any choice or any alternatives. Both you and your father must come to meet the principal. There is no any alternative. Not only your father, not only you. Both of you. It means both you and your father must come to meet the principal. He is a good dancer. His brother is a good dancer. Both he and his brothers are good dancers. The other example is, my sister is both smart and intelligent. Actually, there are two sentences. My sister is smart, my sister is intelligent. We can join these two sentences by using this connector both and. Thank you very much for listening to me.